Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn all about the conditional operators in C#. You'll learn about the AND operator, the OR operator, and the Ternary operator. If this is your first ever C# video, I'd strongly suggest that you watch the series from the start. Card should be on your screen now. And as always, I'd advise you to download the channel files that accompany this video. Again, the card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. Well, what is a conditional operator? According to Wikipedia, a conditional operator is a type of operator. Conditional operators are present in many fields. A conditional operator is similar to, but not equivalent to, a logical operator. Well, that has to be the worst explanation for anything I've ever heard, yes. But the true explanation more than likely lies in the operator it's similar to. So let's find out what a logical operator is. According to Wikipedia, a logical connective, also called a logical operator, is a symbol or word used to connect two or more sentences of either a formal or a natural language in a grammatically valid way, such that the sense of the compound sentence produced depends only on the original sentences. A logical connective is similar to, but not equivalent to, a conditional operator. In the grammar of natural languages, two sentences may be joined by a grammatical conjunction to form a grammatically compound sentence. Some, but not all, such grammatical conjunctions are truth functions. Consider the following sentences. A. Jack went up the hill. B. Jill went up the hill. C. Jack went up the hill and Jill went up the hill. The words and so are grammatical conjunctions joining the sentences A and B to form the compound sentences C and D. The and in C is a logical connective since the truth of C is completely determined by A and B. It would make no sense to affirm A and B but deny C. I love that a fairly basic concept can be made to sound pretty complex when explained out, or at least it does to me, yes. Here we are only concerned with the connective conjunction, represented by the logic gate and disjunction, represented by the logic gate OR. In C#, the conditional AND is represented by two ampersand signs, and the conditional OR is represented by two vertical bars. Let's see these bad boys in action, Ace. Open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, Ace, make sure you give your script a different name than any other class in your project. Okay, let's log out a number of examples demonstrating the AND operator in action. And I'll also log out the same conditions with the OR operator. Save the script, head back into Unity. Drag our script onto one of the game objects in our scene and run the game. And you'll see that our console gets flooded with results. Let's go through these slowly, yes. For the condition true and true, we get true. False and true gives false. And false gives us false. The other AND condition should produce the same result, yes. From these results, we can see that both conditions need to be true in order to yield a true result. So both A and B must be true. This may seem a bit tedious, yes, but it is incredibly important that this stuff is hammered home. With the OR operator, we get true with the condition true or true, true with the condition false or true, and false with the condition false or false. Here we can quite clearly see the difference between and OR. With OR, when one of the conditions are true and the other one is false, the result will still be true. Basically, this is saying if A or B is true, then our statement is true. Superbly easy, I'm sure, yes. You can also string several statements together, like so. Here the statement reads false, or true and false and true, or true and true. Since the first part is false, we move past it and on to the next part, true and false and true. We know that this statement is false here, since all the conditions are not true. So once again, we move on to the next part. True and true. Hey, hey, this statement is true, and so our entire statement is true. I personally hate writing statements like this here, since I usually find it tricky figuring out which conditions group together. Fortunately, the great C-sharp gods allow us to encapsulate the statements into brackets. If you remember back to the basic operators video, the card is on your screen in case you missed that, Ace, you'll remember that with BODMIS, brackets come first. And I believe that after that, the ORs take precedence over the ANDs. Using brackets like this can make this statement much easier to read. Another technique you can use, Ace, is to store the different parts into Boolean variables. Like so. Using this little trick, you can make the statement much easier to read, and you can even describe what is happening with the names of the variables themselves. We'll discover similar techniques like this in later videos. These conditions can also be used in an if statement, but I'm sure that's fairly obvious by now, eh, yes? You may also be a bit annoyed at the fact that, much like the equality operator, you have to use two ampersands for AND instead of just using one. But wait a second, Ace, you can just use one. Yes, unlike the equals equals operator, you can use a single ampersand for and a single vertical line for OR to get the exact same result. So why have I been showing you the double operator all this time? Ah, well, this is the thing, Ace, they are two different operators. According to MSDN, these are called logical operators and are generally used with bitwise operations. What is a bitwise operation? That shall be saved for a future video, Ace. Remember back to what Wikipedia said, Ace. A conditional operator is similar to, but not equivalent to, a logical operator. Well, so what's the difference? Both appear to give the exact same result. And that is true, Ace. They will give you the same result in your statement, but it's how they arrive at that result that makes them so different. According to MSDN, the conditional AND operator, ampersand, ampersand, performs a logical AND of its bool operands, but only evaluates its second operand if necessary. Let me explain this one a little further, Ace. Here we have an equality comparison between 1 and 2, which will be false, and 2 and 2, which will be true. The overall statement is false because not all the conditions are true. Because we know that all conditions need to be true in a conditional AND for the overall statement to be true, logically there is no point computing the second part of this statement. Why? Well, if the first condition, 1 equals 2 in this case, is false, the overall statement will be false regardless of the outcome of the second condition. This is known as short circuit evaluation, and is exactly what the conditional operators do. That's the two ampersands, is. The logical operator, represented by 1 ampersand ace, will not do this, and so will compute the second operation even though there is no chance of the overall statement ever being true. Well, what's the big deal? I mean, it's only 1 or 2 unnecessary operations being carried out for the sake of better readability. Well, that might be true for a statement that isn't run that often, ace, but consider a statement that is constantly being checked. Say our program was looped 1 million times. In terms of gaming, that would be the equivalent of playing a game for about 5 hours. If we have a basic statement with two conditions, the chances of this statement needing to be fully computed would be astronomical, since our statement would have to be false and true for the entire 5 hours. Actually, if that was the case, Ace, you'd have to seriously ask yourself if there was much point in that statement being there in the first place, since the conditions clearly don't change that often. The point here is that all those wasted operations could be saved if you used the conditional operators. Hopefully I haven't bored you too much with that explanation, Ace, but as you begin to start working on a game yourself, you'll see that making these micro-optimizations can really start to add up. Right, now all that's out of the way, let's have a look at the ternary operator. According to MSDN, the conditional operator, ?, returns one of two values depending on the value of a Boolean expression. Okay, for this I'm going to declare a string called str. Next, I'm going to make a very basic if statement. If true, set str equal to true. Else, set str to false. All very familiar for the moment, yes. But what if I was to tell you that all of this can be condensed into just one line? Like so. This is our ternary expression, yes. It has the exact same logic as the previous if statement, but is somewhat easier to read. ReSharper is also clever enough to detect that our previous if statement can be converted to a ternary expression. Simply click on the ifs text, press Alt and Enter, and click Convert to question mark colon operator. You have to admit, yes, that's pretty marvelous. Ternary expressions can also be nested as well, but I personally detest this since I find it very difficult to read. This has been a fairly good look at the conditional operators in C#. You can now create complicated if statements using this logic. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes, I trust you are well. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with a basic if statement. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.